diving into it. You don't have to set it like a tight set on a net. Just wherever you feel you're comfortable making contact with the ball, toss it up there and do your approach and hit. And try and do it, I guess, about three in each position. You got that? Like the E, the two, and the four.
Thank you. are which. At the same time, they're learning, you know, because the arc and where they go have numbers.
Mm-hmm.
Four, a two, and a five on that back, in their back set. There's also others that she's not covering, which is fine. She doesn't give too much information. But it's good that they're learning what they're called. Because when you read the coaching material, then you understand what they're talking about. This drill is running a little too slow. But about right now, I would probably put one of the students on the other side and mirror the drill. Because they're getting bored, and you can tell by their body language they're getting a little bored. Down here, it's worse. If they can do something 80% as well, they're doing it right here. So you make them a ball machine for a little while, and then you rotate out to somebody else who has the ball machine. In high school, you couldn't do that in fourth grade.
No.
I'm not just telling you for you. It's much easier when you're not actually running the pitch, right?
I want y'all to follow y'all approaches at the net. Let's start with.
Thank you.
pass through. We've been practicing it for a while. I have no idea. Don't want to talk anything else. That's it. And if we take this same drill and make it competitive in nature, more game-like, where you score points, then they're going to want to keep practicing and do it well.
Like split them up like half and half, and then have her toss the ball to one side and then someone else toss it to the other, and then whoever gets the most points in a certain amount of time.
Yeah, and it's okay to do this as a technical drill at first. We can't do this 20 minutes. Look at the body language of the people on the court. Okay. And she's doing a good job motivating them to be in good people. But still, 20 minutes, and this is college. Can you imagine if they were really 13-year-olds? do not get bored holding the camera because it keeps you actively engaged as well. And everybody wants to play. When you know it's done, you can get body language of the people standing. And then you're looking at your watch every 5 minutes, wondering when you're going to get across. This should never, ever happen when you get across. You should be the best salesman in the school. Because if we do not, if they don't love it, and they get out of school, they're not going to do it.
True.
I think she's doing a very good job giving feedback and actually teaching the skill.
Yeah,
she is. She's actually, and her confidence, I love her presence.
Mm-hmm.
She doesn't look like she's scared to be up there. She smiles. I would like to hear them call them by name, but it's early in the semester. That does an overwhelming good thing. If you know your kids' names and you call them by name, and you say something to them, that means they matter. If you don't know their name and you have to call them how you do, it's a real negative thing in your class. So you spend a lot of time at the beginning of the school year learning those names real quick. Time management is much better. She's telling her when to stop. But I would say, number one, that your reporting there is better at presence and motivation.
Yeah.
Why don't you go down the other side and shoot from the opposite side?
Your second.
Great.